Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Android Studio, that is Android Studio version Jellyfish on the Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World Android project on our Android Studio and then how to run that right on our Android phone itself. So you don't need to install any emulator or anything, everything you can do right on your Android phone itself. So I'm going to show you all of that. I'm going to also show you how you can save lot of space and how to run smoothly your Android Studio without any issues. So you do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues, then you can always comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install Android Studio, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and to just simply search over here, Android Studio download, and hit enter, and immediately you'll be able to see this download Android Studio as a first source link. So you need to click on this Android Studio and it's going to redirect to the official site of Android Studio. So this link I'm going to provide right in our description, so you can directly use that link to land over here. And once you are here, you'll be able to see this Android Studio download Android Studio Jellyfish option. So at the time I'm making of this video, latest version is Android Studio Jellyfish. So I'm going to download that. So I'm going to select that and you need to scroll down and you can click on dismiss over here, and then you need to check these terms and condition, and then you need to click on this download Android Studio Jellyfish. So when you click on that, immediately you'll be able to see that it is rightly started downloading our Android Studio. So I have already downloaded it. So I'll close this, I'll minimize my browser, I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our Android Studio is rightly downloaded over here. So to just simply double click on it to start installing our Android Studio, and you can see the file size also, it is 1.11 of gigabyte. Alright, so it will ask you for administrative privileges, click on yes. And let's minimize our download directory. So welcome to Android Studio setup, just simply click on next. So here is the point where I'm going to show you how to save some space. Alright, so first thing is you need to uncheck this Android virtual device. As soon as you uncheck that, you can see lot of space is already synced. We don't need any virtual device, alright, everyone is pretty much using an Android phone. So you can directly use your Android phone itself for creating this project and for running and debugging that project, alright. So you don't need any virtual device for that, alright. Only thing is you need to have a USB cable and your Android phone, that's all. Alright, so that's why you are unchecking that. Everything I am going to show you on this video itself, don't worry. So just uncheck that, click on next. So here our Android Studio is going to be installed, totally fine, click on next. So Android Studio folder it's going to create, totally fine, click on install. So it's going to start installing our Android Studio. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. And you can see that our Android Studio is successfully installed, click on next. So completing Android Studio setup, start our Android Studio, click on finish. And there you go. Can see our Android Studio started launching. So first it will ask whether you'd like to import your previous settings. So do not import previous settings, click on OK, and it's going to start launching our Android Studio. So welcome to Android Studio, click on next. So under installation type, it will ask you whether you'd like to go with standard installation or you want to do custom installation. So as I have told you, we will be doing custom installation, so we are going to select custom and then we are going to click on next. So here is the place where we will be unchecking lot of things. So first we are going to uncheck Android virtual device. Immediately you can see 1.44 gigabyte of space, it's going to just simply shrink. Then we are going to uncheck these two options as well. Only thing that we'll need is our Android 14.2 and then our Android SDK, and all other things we are going to simply uncheck. Alright, and then just simply click on next and next again. So these are all it's going to install, click on next. You need to accept this license agreement, click on accept, select this, click on accept, and then click on finish. So now it's going to start downloading all these different packages like Android SDK, Android 14.0, all those things, and then it's going to install it. So it's going to take some time. You need to have active internet connection right throughout this installation, as it's going to fetch all the files and then it's going to install it locally on your system. So it is very important to have active internet connection. So it will take some time. Once when it is done, I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back. So now you can clearly see all the things are properly downloaded. So just simply click on finish. So welcome to Android Studio, our Android Studio Jellyfish version 2023.3.1, which is latest version at the time of making of this video. So welcome to Android Studio, it's directly launched. So let's maximize this and create our new project. So just simply click on new project. So that will open this new project window. So here you can see we have a lot of activities. So you can choose any activities. If you are into gaming, you can select this game activity and all these different activities as well. So I'm going to select empty activity. We are going to start, you know, fresh. So we are going to select a completely brand new empty activity. And then I'm going to click on next. So here you need to provide your application name. So let's give the application name as Hello Android. And this is going to be our package, so com.example.helloandroid as our package name, and this is where our project is going to be created. So on our users directory, it's going to create a folder called Android Studio Projects, and under that folder, it's going to create our project called Hello Android. Alright, so all the projects that you are going to create on our, you know, Android Studio will be deciding on this Android Studio Projects folder. Alright. And minimum SDK will be API 24, that is Android version 7.0. So you can see about 96.3% of the devices will be having at least Android 7.0 and above. So that's why you are using, that is the minimum SDK version. So all the devices who are using at least Android 7 and above, so all those devices will get supported. Alright, and we are going to use Kotlin as our, you know, default or recommended language. So I'm going to click on finish, and it's going to create our Hello Android project over here. So you can see what's new in Jellyfish. So it is, you know, started indexing our project and going to prepare our project. So it will take some time. It will going to fetch some of the files again from internet, like Gradle and all, and then it's going to, you know, install it. So it will take some time, about 2 to 3 minutes, I'd say. So let's wait for some time. And now you can clearly see that our project is properly updated. So one thing that I want to mention over here, that it really took a lot of time, about 10 minutes, I'd say. So don't worry if it's taking a lot of time. So I'm going to tell you that do not worry. So it's going to do all its, you know, job at the back end, so you don't need to worry anything. So ultimately it will get done. All right and once when it get done, you're not going to see anything that is, you know, running over here. So you're going to see a proper screen like this. So you need to maximize this, and you can see that our project is Hello Android is properly opened over here. And here is our what's new in Jellyfish. You can always read this beautiful article. So that's going to also talk about this, you know, AI Gemini. So how you can use this studio bot in Gemini, everything you can, you know, read about all this. If you need a detailed video, you can always comment. I'm going to make a video about this also. So here is our project. So if we expand our app, you're going to see this manifest and Kotlin plus Java folder over here. So to expand this folder, and here you'll get this package called com.example.helloandroid. So if you expand this again, you're going to see the file called mainactivity.kt, and that same file is exactly opened over here. So here you can see that file code. All right so now let's minimize our what's new in Jellyfish. Here is our project. So we are developing it is in Kotlin. So Kotlin, then mainactivity.kt, that is the Kotlin file, is already been opened over here. Right, so here is our code. So if you, you know, click on this split screen, it's going to show you the design over here. So for that, first you need to click on this build and refresh, and it's going to start building our project, and it's going to show you the design part over here. So let's wait for a minute. And there you go. You can see the output, right? Hello, Android. So basically, you know, I am using i3 processor, i3 11th generation processor. So as many of my, you know, students are keep on asking that, sir, I have i3, so whether I'll be able to install Android Studio, whether I'll be able to run Android Studio and all that. So yes, you can do that. Okay, I am currently doing in i3 itself, so you can do that. So only thing is, probably you will need SSD. SSD will be very helpful, as you know, probably if you are using hard disk, then you might see some sort of lag issue. But if you are using SSD, I'd say it is totally fine. SSD 8GB of RAM and i3 11th gen or 10th gen will actually do. All right. So yeah, so here we can see the hello world, hello Android on the design plate. So let's say you want to, you know, change something here. Like, let's say we have hello, right? So let's say we want to change with hello instead of hello. Let's say we are changing with hi. So as we change that, immediately you can see it is compiling, and here it is loading, and you can see the output hi Android, right? So whatever change you are making, immediately it's going to reflect it over here. So now the question is how we can run this project on our Android phone, right? So for that, the first thing that you need to do is you need to, you know, pick up your USB cable, and you need to connect that in your laptop over that cable and your phone, right? So this is I think everybody has done that. So you need to connect your laptop with the USB. I'm currently doing that, and in phone it's going to ask you that whether you'd like to allow access to your phone data. So you need to click on allow over here, and as soon as you do that, it will again ask you whether you'd like to allow USB debugging. You need to again do allow for that, and when you do that, you can see that Samsung phone SM-AM12 7G phone is actually gets, you know, recognized over here, right? And when you get that device recognized within Android Studio, it click on this run button. So when you click on run button, what happens in the background is it you know, going to start building our project. And if it gets successfully builded, so let's say you don't have any errors on your program, so then only it will get successfully builded. Okay, so when it gets successfully builded, it's going to push that code, you know, as an APK format into our phone. So in our phone, you will be able to see shortly that this, you know, Hello Android app going to be installed there and going to be also launched over there, right? So it takes some time, so let's wait for some time. So you can see that our installed successfully, so Gadel build is finished, and in our phone you can see the output Hi Android, right? So you can clearly see that that is coming. So in this way you can easily install Android Studio, you can easily, you know, create Android project, you can easily use your Android phone itself to, you know, to do all sort of testing that you are developing within Android Studio. So only one thing that I'd like to mention is probably you might not get straightforwardly connected with your phone. So that's because probably the developer option might not be enabled. So for that, you need to go to settings over here, and need to, you know, scroll down, and here you can see that we already have developer option enabled, right? So that is because I have enabled that. So I am going to show you how you can enable that. So you need to have this developer option enabled. So only when it is enabled, then only you'll be able to connect with your laptop. Okay, so for that, you need to, you know, let's first disabled our developer option, then only I'll show you. So now I am disabling it. So I have disabled it. So let's go back. So now you no longer going to see that developer option, right? Only you are seeing only about phone. So you need to click on this about phone, and then you need to click on this build number. So you have to keep on clicking on this build number, then it will show you this the pattern. So we'll give the pattern, and now you can see that developer mode is turned on. So you have to keep on clicking this build number for some time. So it doesn't matter what phone you are using, you basically understood the point, right? You need to go to your about section, then go to software information, and then you need to click on the build number. So you can see on Google also like how you can enable a developer option on your phone. So probably if you are using Redmi, you probably need to sign into some sort of account, they will probably ask you. So it varies from phone to phone, but you basically understood the point, right? The point is you need to have developer option enabled. Once you have that, you go back and you can see that developer option is right now there. So go there, and here you need to again scroll down and to enable this USB debugging. Enable that. Click on OK. So once you have that, then only it will ask you that pop-up. So accept this, allow, and you'll be able to see your phone right on your Android Studio itself. All right. So that is another point that I wanted to mention. So probably in my previous videos, I have already talked about this. Probably you might not have seen those things. So that's why I wanted to repeat that again. All right. So yeah, so that's how you enabled your developer option, and you enabled your phone as a developer option, and you connect that over your Android Studio. All right. So yeah, that's pretty much all about this video. I know this video is a bit long, but I hope I was able to help you. So I was able to explain all the things related to Android Studio and how to create project and all that and use your Android phone itself. Right. So that's basically all about this video. I have also started a Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And you can also follow a lot of our other tutorials. Like recently I have posted one video on how to prepare a free e-commerce website using WordPress. So you can follow, you know, these videos as well. So you'll get all this playlist under our playlist. So do, you know, navigate our channel and follow some of my other tutorials as well. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.